the health and the stability of vegetation is super important for, you know, everything that depends on them. And humans are no exception. As the climate has warmed and as the precipitation patterns have changed across California, there are tracts of forests that we've been referring to as zombie forests that, you know, are still standing today, but it looks like the climate has changed such that they might not be standing tomorrow. They're cheating death in a way, and that's how we've been thinking about it. And as soon as some kind of disturbance event in California, this is probably a wildfire, shakes things up, they won't rise again. They won't keep standing. What vegetation climate mismatch does is it kind of erodes the stability of vegetation, its ability to exist into the future. We compared the movement upward in elevation of these conifer trees to the movement of their happy temperature range upward in elevation, and we found that the temperature was moving at about 3 to 5 times the rate that the trees were. So there was a lag there. Talking to some land managers outside of academia, something that's come up a few times is the need for information on how to prioritize some areas over others. We wanted to map out all the areas in the Sierra Nevada where these forests exactly were outpaced by climate change. Understanding these areas that are likely changing vegetation in the coming decades is important for understanding how wildfires will move across the landscape in the coming years as well. It really forces us to ask questions about, you know, what species kind of belong where and what responsibility people have to maintain ecosystems as they have been or facilitate transitions to kind of the ecosystems of the future.